kind day to you all. I am Kinsmarck.
I'm Violeta.
And this is Chapter 1 of The Division, the cover shooter MMO TPS that just came out from Ubisoft. I covered this game's testing period to completion just a few weeks ago, so at this point, I just want to check into its actual intro, which was cut from that phase, and its character creation, and explore from there. I can't say I have any intention of covering it in its completion, like to all of its entirety as far as the story is concerned, because I've heard some of the early criticisms of the game, which is much of what I anticipated, that it is an entertaining, it is a satisfying, however concerningly shallow in terms of content and story sort of experience. So one that it is in fact the conflict with other players, the actual the combat in the game, etc. that actually serves as, you know, the incentive to keep playing. So I can't say I'm all that concerned with covering all of the story, which means that this stream series will probably end up kind of intermittent as I just kind of stream it as I feel like it.
Whenever we feel like. Uh-huh. And that guy says, well, nice of you to have a live stream before you left for Cali, albeit right after you uploaded a video saying there wouldn't be a stream this week.
I didn't say there wouldn't this week. I just said it wasn't this Friday, because that's actually the day we leave.
We are leaving
so,
Friday early in the morning, the wee hours.
Yeah. So I'm feeling the crunch to create enough content to cover while I'm away. And this
Scarlet
is one of the things I wanted to cover prior to then, because I don't want to put, you know, another week until I cover this.
Yeah.
So let's see
here.
Let's keep this English
subtitles
on confirm.
Yes.
And accept. All right. So that seems
pretty good.
Acceptable. I'm hoping I can actually see a proper intro cutscene. And there we are.
Even though this Black Friday, you can sleep back.
Black Friday all over the region.
Retailers are calling this their super.
149,000 stores offering
millions
sales
of dollars
in the
cash
greater
sales changing hands.
Clever.
The flu season is off its earliest.
Appears to be a previously unknown variant of the flu.
Really?
Suspected case catching many experts off guard.
Today I was feeling like maybe I was.
The breaking news leading with unconfirmed reports of a
smallpox outbreak is a highly rehearsed scenario.
And National Guard units converging
no
on a hospital
trains,
in central
the bridges
Manhattan.
Are closed. It's
smallpox
zone.
Is a very real
more
danger.
More than AIDS. More than Ebola.
No.
Let me stop you there. This is not a panic situation.
An entire American city.
Green poison. Central Park has been converted to a mass burial ground.
Power outages, gas line leaks, fires. The government
we're expecting another night of widespread looting.
The people of New York are begging.
What would it cost?
Your first responders are either dead.
No resources available.
And treated like animals.
It's not a job. We're not trained for.
We were activated. We knew the situation was bad. Worse than anyone knew. We're an elite, highly skilled group of embedded agents. They only call us when everything else has failed. We have no rules. We have no limits. Our job is to protect what remains.
We are your co-workers. We are your neighbors. We might even be your friends.
But when we get the call,
we leave everything behind.
We are
the Division.
Start. All right then.
This is a character creation stream.
All right.
That was really cool.
That was a yeah.
Douches. No, it's just that video made me a germaphobe.
Yeah, that kind of makes me want to, like, hand sanitize.
And Tree says, what's up? Okay. How are you guys? I'm doing good. Just put food away after Jake got home from errands.
I am all right.
Very cool.
Very cool.
Can we see how much?
Yeah, let me check and see what the options are. So it seems like there's a fair amount in the way of presets.
Yeah.
So.
That's good. That guy says, so random question. Enemy within, I just unlocked meld enhancements. Do you think the one that decreases heal time by 66% is worth it?
I couldn't really say.
No. And that guy says, also, pretty good opening.
I'm gonna try and keep this relevant to this.
Ooh.
So, alright then. Seems like it.
That's cool. How many skin tones are there?
There's a fair amount. There's a decent palette. And
not too many hairs, it looks like.
As I said, I am kind of feeling a little of the fatigue from creating a lot of content, so I am fairly low-key this evening.
Scarlett wants
just so
to
everyone
show
is clear.
You the F5 that they made during last stream.
Cool. I approve. There's only a small handful of hairs, it seems, which is kind of a shame.
Yeah. I mean, maybe they'll release more.
Yeah, and
I mean, they might release,
perhaps,
like,
customization is something that one can, like,
later.
Pick up collectibles to add to.
Oh, that's nasty.
Kind of a low-res texture for that scar, though. Like, I can see the pixelation from here.
Maybe our options aren't set to what it should be.
Yeah, because as is so clearly prevalent in so many AAA games, I couldn't access any kind of menu for settings and customization prior to launching, because so many AAA games are so excited to get you straight into it that they forget to actually do things like user-friendly menus. I'm feeling kind of critical, just so everyone is clear. Whoa.
That guy says, hey, why did the console gamer cross the street? This one's pretty funny.
I don't know.
To render the building on the other side.
that's
pretty good.
That's clever.
That one's pretty good.
So, there are more face paints, sorry, war paints, than there are hair options.
That seems very backwards.
That's strange.
Okay. Whoa.
Oh, there's some tattoos.
That's cool.
Cool! Samoan tattoos. I like it.
I like Samoan. That's cool.
Yeah, they have some of the coolest tattoo patterns in the
Ooh.
World, as far as my taste
I
is
like
concerned.
I like that one, too.
That is
cool. What's that look
That's
like?
That's one side of the neck. Oh, geez. There's a lot of tattoos.
Oh, nice.
And there's saturation. All right, cool.
No, it says, no,
so,
it's not low res. She has a rare condition that heals her scars in cuboid shape. She's a cubic crystal structure. Don't judge. Oh, dude.
I'll check my crystal privilege.
Oh, my gosh.
Shades.
So,
all right.
Oh,
ooh,
no.
I like them.
We
all
can
right.
go XCOM.
Yeah. All right, let's see here.
My guy's like, you're right, Nomad. How could we not notice?
Change to male.
What
that guy that? Looks kind of aggressive. Alright, let's see.
He's so
dope. Is the,
I really liked the, Middle Eastern.
Hey! He's still here!
I kind of liked the Middle Eastern guy.
Yeah, he looked kind of cool. I want to check all of these. Alright, so 7 is the guy that I had.
Your
from
Mr.
The testing period. He looks kind of cool,
like,
too.
Can we make Desmond?
I could probably get kind of close. Let me see what this guy looks like with facial hair.
Yeah.
Because the other guy, he looks a little older than I necessarily want.
Yeah.
So.
I kind of want, you know, I think young and intense.
Yeah.
Fun, you know?
Let me see what I can do with this guy.
Some nice. I wonder if the skin tones shift based on what preset you're using.
Probably.
Like, go to one of the.
Because one of the presets is, yeah. Like,
go,
where's
go to one of,
this
yeah.
guy?
Check these presets.
Yeah, the skin tone palette shifts according to ethnicity. That's kind of
cool.
Okay,
that's a cool.
That's sort
way
of an efficient system
yeah.
in terms of the coloration.
Okay, I thought that
okay.
might be right.
See. Yeah,
no,
that was the one.
Give
I liked.
That man aviators.
Can we do this? Right, I kind of like those. I do like that the eye color palettes are static, so you could have whatever color for whatever ethnicity you want. Kind of like that one. So let's see here. Hair. Can I give him like facial hair? Here we go.
Yes, you can.
There we go. That helps him. That helps even more. That's too much. Ah.
There we go.
All right, so keep
his
hair dark.
Hair,
I do want to see what the colors and stuff are.
Some of these are nice.
Those
they're
are actually pretty acceptable.
Good.
The
those
gray is actually
bad.
Decent. I'll keep it dark, though. All right, let's
that
see.
That guy says, I love the thought that New York is in ruins. People are running around with loaded firearms, not thinking twice about shooting someone, and you're just staring at your reflection across the road.
Yeah, you know,
yeah, well,
priorities. Wait, is that a slider? No, those are just weird lines attached to the sides of the menus for
some reason. Oh, it's telling you which menu you're on.
Yeah.
Because if you go down to the facial hairstyle.
That comes down there. All right.
They're telling you what you're selecting.
I think I'll stick with this one.
I kind of like that one,
yeah. All right, so markings. Scar.
You know what makes me sad, though, is that you can only have presets. There's no...
Yeah, there aren't any sliders.
And,
oh, jeez, he's got like a Kenshin scar.
Oh, it's kind of cool looking now.
I may stick with that, because, fun fact,
cool.
I actually kind of have a very small one. It used to show up a lot more, and it came from when...
It's slowly healing.
Yeah, it's several years old at this point. When my friend and I were training for, like, anti-sword combat kind of thing, and it was pretty late, and I was pretty fatigued, and I misjudged how capable I was at the time. Given how tired I was, and I couldn't react fast enough, and instead of completely deflecting an incoming slash away, you know, leveraging against the flat side of the blade and pushing, instead it just kind of slid up my arm, and then it just caught me straight in the face. It was
so close to losing your eye.
Yeah, it was concerningly close. It was wooden, mind you. These were training swords. It just, the impact splits the skin right there at, I think it's the occipital is what that area is called.
Pattern.
Yeah, and it was like a star pattern there for, and it was, I'd say about a half inch wide for several years. It kind of looked cool. And the funny thing is, I think it like crushed the nerves on impact, so I could hardly feel it. Like, I kept on, you know, in the training fight, and it was only when he was just like, dude, your shirt's kind of a mess. I was like, what? Oh, God. And then we had to go. And funny thing, I know I've just, like, gone off into story time. We headed to our dorm because I was in college at the time. And when we came into the lobby, everyone was looking. Did y'all just get into, like, a pub fight or something? Like, who did that to you? I'm like, him. And when he's, like, walking in, they're like, is he okay? Like. It was funny. So I may stick with that just for personal story.
Full time sake.
Oh jeez, that's like...
What's that?
Chemical
is that
all
like
across,
water?
Yeah.
Oh.
And then of course,
that's like
the classic, because that's in every game. I think I will, I'll stick with the...
I like the X-Star.
The cross pattern
nice.
There.
Alright, what we got?
Alright, we got a lot of paints here. There's primary, secondary, and tertiary paints, so you can customize the hell out of these.
I don't know what some of these are.
They're pretty much just camo patterns that are meant to obfuscate one's silhouette. Which is a little strange, considering I'm in an urban environment. I'm not exactly going to camouflage myself with just detritus on the street.
Yeah.
It seems like there's a strange confusion of priorities in terms of what they should flesh out in this character customization. All right, tattoos, because I am.
Says, also, okay, my school wants another interview. This is 6 or 7.
Just mind yourself. I definitely want to ink this guy up.
That's really cool.
I like that one. On that same side as the scar.
Yeah. But there's, like, so many for us to... Oh, no,
of course,
no,
the neck spider.
I don't like
you can play
spider.
As the Cervarium character.
I don't want the neck spider.
Okay. Quilts, alright.
Weird chest patterns, okay.
If you want to look like a car seat cover from a taxi cab, there's a tattoo for that. That's a skull spade kind of pattern. Another skull.
Oh.
So, just to engage.
Is that a Celtic knot?
The chat, yeah. Any theories as to exactly, accepting that they are, in fact, in this story, their own, like, component of governmental disaster response kind of teams. If they were real world, though, what, like, alphabet agency would you say that these guys are part of? I would say NSA.
Yeah,
because they
seem... I'd say NSA or CIA.
CIA can't operate on American soil.
That
in
has
theory.
To stop them before.
At
they
least
say they bring them in when nothing else will work.
I know. Still
no,
though.
No, it says I'm gonna agree, but ask for some prep items. That guy says, okay, so Project Brazil will be releasing between early May and the end of summer, and the Frontier is nearly done as well.
I want the Frontier.
Just my
modding so
news
much.
For this stream.
Oh, I want
it's
the Frontier.
A dragon.
It's pretty cool.
It's a dragon. It's another dragon, but I like the other one better. It's a face.
That's kind of cool.
I think it's a face. It's weird seeing two, like, eyeballs, though, right there.
Yeah. I think I'm going to go with that one
that?
Side of the neck pattern. That one is Jailhouse Ink. Because...
Yeah.
I have seen that, I'll just say.
I like that one.
Yeah, I'm sticking with this one.
Tattoo saturation.
Yeah, so that's how dark it is. We'll go with...
No, it says, I love how interviews are what have made me a cynic. Not bullying, not stress, nope. Interviews. And that guy says CDC, perhaps, sent in to contain a disease and the results of the outbreak.
Yeah, I could see them as like a combat response... in a environmentally hazardous environment,
yeah,
sort of team.
Work.
So CDC
you know,
could actually work.
Guns and survival experience.
Yeah. That's actually kind of similar to some of the story from Siphon Filter.
Is it?
Yeah.
That's a good... Isn't that one a good...
Oh, that's an excellent series. It was in its
have,
heyday in the PlayStation era.
But we don't have the first one.
I do.
Do we?
I have the first, second, and third...
Does it work?
At this point, I couldn't say. Cause
is it blue disc?
No, it's just so old, and the laser on my console is
like,
kind of finicky. All right, let's see here. Piercings and glasses.
He needs a hood.
He does.
I'm just going to say,
well,
he needs to rock the assassin
ooh,
hood. I'm
he can
sorry.
Actually kind of rock those little earrings.
He
that's something that
I'm
a little curious to see is if they tie this game... into the greater Ubisoft universe, because it's pretty much confirmed at this point that the Far Cry and Assassin's Creed series are one and the same in terms of the setting.
IP. They have
and
said that this is a new IP, so
Watch Dogs is also a part of that, because Aiden Pierce can work for the Assassins in
so cool.
a little like side mission Easter egg kind of thing.
Which is really
and
cool.
Abstergo crates are found in a certain mission in Far Cry 3. So that links all of them. I'm curious to see
if
this is,
too,
this is also a part.
That, which means I think this guy should be an assassin.
Yeah, I think so.
I'm just gonna go with...
Well, and if he's a part of some kind of, like, elite team, then he would probably have the skills that would get him recruited for such a team.
I don't think this glasses really work with him.
No, not for him. They don't really match his kind of attitude.
No. Different.
You need, like, a Ron Perlman kind of face for these glasses. So...
I kind of like the... What are the other earrings?
Those were pretty much it.
So there's one earring set.
I'm going to go with the little earrings, because he can actually he can pull those off. I like them. All right. So...
Oh, I like that little smirk he's got going there. It's like...
Confirm. Activate agent.
We have been activated.
Authorizing. I'm armed already.
Attachment system analytic computer is activated. All ISAC systems are confirmed online.
Garrus?
Alright, purchase available.
To cover the marker to begin weapon verification.
So that is Garrus' voice, right?
Yeah, oh yeah. It's the same as from the previous period. Let's see.
Okay, let's see.
Can I check my inventory?
That guy says,
so...
it bothers me that in the background the streetlight's yellow-colored light flashes for much less time than it should.
So I have an MP5 and an M9 and some gear. I also completed some of the missions on the promo sites for this game prior to its actual release. So I should, come to think of it, actually have some things in my appearance slots. Let's see. Alright, maybe I still need to activate those. Or maybe I just need to complete the intro segment. And, I know what they probably are. They're in, my, like, stash crate, I'd imagine. Can anyone confirm that? Has anyone else done those things? Okay, he looks very different when the camera zooms out than he did up close.
Can you go to the,
He looks very different. Can I change him later?
Can we look at the, options? Maybe we can up the res and stuff.
Yeah, let me check on that stuff.
Let's
see, settings.
Because I feel like that might be part of the problem, is that it's...
Also, audio, let me turn that down so I can cut some of the echo out of the stream. I'll take it down to 30. And disable VoIP.
No, it says you play items? I zoned out.
I think for this game... I'll keep my microphone enabled. Voice chat. No, I do not want auto talk. Push to talk, thank you. Now then, video. Alright, so it's proper resolution, 60Hz refresh rates.
What's monitor zero?
Graphics. That's for if you have multiple monitors.
Yeah, graphics quality low.
Oh, jeez, no freaking wonder.
Everything is low.
How high can it go? Let's just... set it up to ultra and see what happens to the frame rate. V-Sync, kill that, thank you. Frame rate limit, off. Shadow quality, high. Spot shadow counts. PostFX, AA. We'll make you...
Retrieved items appear in a special low. Stash, if that's what you mentioned.
Cool. Alright.
So F is apply.
Wow, there's actually a sharpen image slider? Alright. Particle detail, cool.
Lots of
volumetric fog, reflection quality, anisotropic filtering. Let's turn that down because that actually kills performance, which means
parallax
things will look
a
little jaggy. Ambient occlusion, we'll keep that high. Depth
that
of field,
low. Low. The graphics quality is low by default.
Apparently. Chromatic aberration, lens flare.
What's
right, cool. That's for some of the cinematic effects. All right, apply. Keep these changes.
Okay, let's.
Hold on, let me check the rest of this. Visuals. I do like that they have a colorblind mode. Because I'm always happy to see, especially when AAA developers include stuff like that for people with impairments. That's kind of cool. Distance
units
metric. No,
it says it might be a guy or a box, but there is a designated reward dealer guy.
Okay.
Okay.
Language, third party, cool. Alright, so I think I'm in the clear.
Shall we check it out?
Yeah, let me see, because... Well, the textures have certainly improved. He still looks very different. This is as far as I can scroll in. I hate when games do that.
But he looked... Like, go back to the menu.
Wait a minute. Oh, because I was looking at a reflection. That's why I'm like, wait a minute, his thing is on the wrong side. That's... It isn't clever. It's idiocy. I mean, I know I'm kind of stupid for it... It isn't clicking at the time. Having your character creation menu a reflection when you have asymmetrical character creation options is kind of stupid. Because it means that you aren't actually looking at what you'll see when you look at the character for the rest of the game. Coming out the gate with some criticism here.
That guy says, okay, gotta admit, it was a good amount of options. It was.
Yeah, it is.
Can you look from the menu again?
Hang on. I just want to complete this, because I hope there's a thing where it asks if I want to confirm my character, because I certainly do not.
Weapon test initialized. Open fire at the highlighted targets.
Because I can't say I like this guy, since apparently the camera shifted and the angle showed me a different aspect of the mesh, so he actually looks pretty friggin' different from what I saw in the close-up.
Honestly, he looks... It's that right up there.
you want me to shoot? Alright.
Primary weapon test successful.
Switch to sidearm. Alright, done.
Weapon test initialized. Open fire at the highlighted targets.
Kill those paint cans!
Sidearm test successful.
Head to a safe place.
This is Louis Chang, Northeast Section Commander of the Division. You have been activated because Brooklyn has become dangerously unstable. Isaac has updated us with your progress. Proceed to the nearest safe house for your full equipment loadout.
Alright then, I assume you want me to check my map, so consider it checked. Alright.
Does he look like your character, Jack? Like you made him when you were in the menu?
Yeah.
Like, it's only when you're in game.
Agent, I confirm that your fellow agent Faye Lau has arrived here. Check in with her when you get inside.
Is that the lady that was in the helicopter?
Yep. The thing is, in game is what I'm gonna see the most. So that's what I care about the most.
Okay, Noah says, I'm gonna spare you now. I don't believe there's confirmation. You can try going back to the taxi window to see if that helps.
You are now entering a safe area.
Whoa.
Okay. Alright, can I just start a new character prior to getting too far in? Hang on, let me see. There's log out and quit game.
And exit. But that's...
That, I think, is just going to exit this menu.
I don't know.
Warning. You are now leaving the safe area.
I'm aware of that, thank you. It's almost like I did it on purpose or something, because there are controls in this game. Alright, I'm going to check and see what logout does, just for curiosity. Because I want to see if I can create another character. Since apparently I am going to have to stick with the Slav that I had previously. Let's see.
So that's what this he looks like.
That's this guy. He looks so different from here. Okay, then. New game. There we are. Can I just delete him? Yes. There we are. Hold to delete. I'm holding. There we are. Confirmed. All right. Apologies for the hiccup. I just want to actually have a character that I like. So, yeah. There we are. Now let's skip this and just connect straight to the creation menu again. I said skip. I know you think you're loading.
This Black Friday, you can see that.
Retailers are calling this their 49,000 stores.
Can I actually skip, or is that just there to make me feel like I can? No, this is the same thing. I think it just loads the character creation thing underneath us seeing this, and so trying to tell it to skip this, it's like, I ain't ready yet!
Back on the breaking news, leading with unconfirmed reports of a...
Come on with these load times, finally, alright.
We were activated.
Uh-huh, can I skip this too? I cannot.
Worse than anyone what? Knew.
And it...
We are an elite, highly skilled group of embedded agents.
And the audio options are reset.
We have no rules. We have no limits. Our job is to protect what remains.
Uh-huh.
We are your co-workers. We are your neighbors.
We are annoyed.
We might even be your friends.
But when we get the call,
we leave everything behind.
You know, adding might in that sentence is a poor choice of writing.
The division.
Because everyone has friends. So, clearly, to someone, the we are your friends line is applicable. So having might in there isn't at all... And it's, hey, it knows who I want! Alright! Calm down from the frustration. Let's see here. Right, think that is what I had him in previously. So it seems like each preset actually comes with custom hair options. Because these were certainly not available to the other guy. Huh.
Weird.
That's strange.
That's a strange...
Why wouldn't someone of a different ethnic preset have the ability to cut their hair this way? Alright. I'll just keep it. So do I use this one or...
No, it says everyone has friends. The might applies to slash ball.
Alright, that's fair.
That guy says, it's cool that the reflection behaved properly, but it sucks that what you expected your character to look like is going to be reversed.
Exactly. Like, that isn't... I'd call it an inefficient means of creating a character. Edging into misleading. Right, I'll keep his dark hair. Nah, wait, where's his... Hold up. Can I affect his eyes? There, okay, so it's in here. I see. Because see, the thing is, what we're looking at here, since it is rendered on a reflection, we're actually seeing a slightly stretched and distorted version of the character, which is why it looked so different when I changed from the car window to the actual in-game. Like, it's clearly, actually, the camera is looking at a reflection on the window.
Which is cool, but not for character creation.
Nah, it's... They're trying to show off a little too hard, such that it's actually sabotaging its own flow. Alright. So, I think, you know what? I'll give him some, like, piercing dark eyes. There we go. So... Hair is already a keeper. Markings. What can we do with this guy? Are there different scars for each preset? Seems like the same. Well, I mean, they're a little different on his face. So I need to remember that these are going to appear on the other side. A little too large on his face, so I think I'll go no scars, no paints, tattoos maybe? Let's see. And yeah, alright. Confusion continues. So, hairstyles and some other things are confined to certain ethnic presets, whereas tattoos, one of the most culturally oriented customizations one could conceive of for a character, are apparently universal. Come on, Ubisoft. I know you can do more than this. Alright, I ain't so much a fan of that one on him. There was one near the end that I kinda liked. Where was that? That one. Nah, it looks silly on him. Shame as it is to say, I'm actually kind of thinking inkless.
Yeah.
Cause...
Now that guy says, so now that you have the game about people that divide, will you play the game about a man that hits?
Probably not. Cause I can't say I support that company's decisions. I can't say from what I've seen of gameplay of the man that hits, I'm all that impressed. It just doesn't do anything for me, especially since I'm a fan of the classic entries in that series, and the AI is confusingly stupid. It just seems contrived. I don't know. It ain't doing anything for me. And I don't want to support that company while they're making decisions like cutting up everything they're making, because money talks. So as much as, even if they were making a game that I really liked the look of, if they were making corporate choices that I just couldn't approve of, on principle, I couldn't support them. Just because I know that is the only thing that they will hear on a corporate level, and that will actually therefore make change happen. So, ain't happening.
No, it says tried so hard and got so far, plays in the distance.
He cannot rock the earrings. Can he rock the Morpheus shades? Even though they aren't quite that, I know. Because Morpheus shades were actually little pince-nez. Kinda? He just kinda looks like he's wearing reading glasses that are tinted, though.
I don't like it. It's
so...
He's just gonna be the taken guy.
I kinda have to keep this guy kinda plain.
He's Liam Neeson.
Apparently.
I'm sorry.
Okay.
He looks a little like Liam Neeson. Don't even lie. It's
confirm, true. Then. Alright. Shake off the frustration. I know I like this guy, because I played through the entire testing period with him, so... Because this is essentially the same guy.
Can I see him?
Attachment system analytic computer is
activated. That's more like it.
All systems are confirmed.
He's an angry man.
Yes, he is.
Okay, let's get moving.
To begin weapon verification.
I can't even jog for this. I have to meander. Okay.
Initialized. Open fire at the highlighted targets. Primary weapon test successful.
Come on, I know it's coming.
Weapon test initialized. Open fire at the highlighted targets. Sidearm test successful. Welcome aboard.
Okay.
This is Louis Chang, Northeast Section Commander of the Division. You have been activated because Brooklyn has become dangerously unstable. Isaac has updated us with your progress. Proceed to the nearest safe house for your full equipment loadout.
Check.
Agent, I've confirmed that your fellow agent Faye Lau has arrived here. Check in with her when you get inside.
There we are.
Now entering a safe area.
Fast travel to this location. So, gear vendor. Some guy just chilling on the couch. Oh, I love these fictional posters. Cutback, Capo, and Mutiny.
That guy
says it seems good. There's interesting concepts. Look free,
but you shouldn't make level divided sandbox games into episodes.
Mm-hmm. I agree.
Nothing but respect for those folks. I like the puppet saying.
All right. They ain't the only one. So should I check in with this guy?
You got a hell of a selection.
I can't afford anything, so I guess this is just showing me that he's here.
Hmm. Maybe he'll come back later?
Maybe.
Wait, what?
Oh.
Was that him?
We're losing this whole neighborhood. Riders are moving through, in force, headed this way.
Who are your people there? I see someone else got the call. I'm Agent Fei Lau, Division. Activated the same time as you, part of the second wave of us going in. I don't know what happened to the first wave, but unfortunately, there's still lots left for us to do. We don't have much intel, and we don't have the luxury of failure. Not with Manhattan under lockdown and Brooklyn on the brink. People like me, and you, we're what's left to hold the line. With any luck, we'll have more to go on once we rendezvous with the commander. More about the situation, about who's turning the streets into a war zone, anything that's gonna help us do what we're supposed to do. Now, if you'll excuse me, Lieutenant.
Officer Hazen and his team are handling situation reports. If you're looking for a hotspot, that's who you want to talk to.
Complete your activation at the terminal to enable Directive 51 operational status and equipment.
I know who that guy looks like. The guy right in front of me, who I think face I had
it
last
is.
Time. The main character of Heavy Rain. Look at him!
No, he doesn't.
Yes, he does! He looks exactly like him. Look him up. Check it. That is him.
Can I finish my...
Yeah.
Okay. That guy says it's like selling Angry Birds, just an example, into separate $2 packages for every 20 or so levels. Yep. So did it keep our graphics and visuals? Yeah?
I think.
Yeah, Yeah, because it's
did it keep my audio? Yeah, it kept my audio. The game is just loud, apparently.
Yeah.
Alright.
Okay. Oh, that was just music. You didn't change effects or dialogue. There's no, master.
Oh. Okay. I'm just so used to the top slider as a master, I didn't even actually look at the text.
It's okay.
Okay. I'm stupid. Apologies. That actually seems a little low now. Let's just cut you down to 50, and then we'll adjust from there. Cool. All right. Continue. Seriously, just picture this guy running around a park screaming Sean. Okay. Complete activation. So that's matchmaking. I don't want that. Check in here.
Identity confirmed. SHD equipment activated.
Can we
press L, go to abilities, equip a skill. Can do.
Awesome. I can see the guy in front of you walking through the streets of New York screaming, Jason!
So what do we want to do first? Medical is pulse. Tech is sticky.
Sticky bomb!
Sticky bomb! Security is shield. I think I'll go with shield. Because I had that previously, so I'm just acclimating to the abilities I had. So, that one. I'll assign you to E. Cool. Oh, hey, there's actually a little, like, module on my pack for it. That's kind of cool. Okay. Request situation report.
Thank God you're here, Agent. I've never seen Brooklyn like this. We're barely hanging on. I'll be your point of contact for any emergency ops. We've had plenty of action, and it's not letting up.
Those cold, Jesus. Dead eyes!
I'm not gonna have any hair left when this thing is done.
Alright.
What's that?
So, retrieve food supplies. Haven't got anything to do with the computer window, so... Yeah, I think it's time to head out. Alright. Let's get moving.
Warning. Now leaving the safe area.
Isaac can intercept transmissions from locations on the map, so you can get a little more intel on where you're getting into.
Your shots.
Agent, Riders took the weekly food supply from the Brooklyn Heights Distribution Center. They try and sell it back to all the starving people. Plain and simple profiteering on the backs of people who are suffering. Get that food back.
Aye. Can I, like, chat him down? Because this is the kind of thing that I've heard some criticism of in this game, is that if you have a hammer, solution to everything seems like a nail. Can I chat with this guy?
Please.
Is it?
I have a family.
Come on! Go bag. See ya. You're welcome.
Because
considering the severity of the situation that this story is at least attempting to tell, is it fair for me to call it callous that they refer to the items enemies drop as loot? I mean, come on. It just seems a little contradictory to its tone, is all I'm saying.
So now we're supposed to be helping people?
Yeah, we're here supposedly here to help. Loot? It just... It comes across like I'm an adventurer of some kind.
I mean,
I kind of am, especially at the way the game plays.
But still.
Again, it's just... It seems like confused tone.
Approaching marked location.
So, cover to cover. Oh, I have to hold space. All right, there we go.
I'm telling you, it won't budge.
So I assume I can't just confront these guys verbally.
All right, genius. Show me how it's done.
Oh, I'll spell it out for you. Hi.
Secured. Hostiles neutralized.
So, mark for JTF.
Warning. Hostile forces approaching.
I think we've got enough to take
it. Contact! Come on, Fredo. I mean, after what just happened to your friends, you should have all the confidence in the world to charge at me. Mine remains
blind. Is there any form of stealth in this game?
It doesn't seem like it. As like, once you make initial contact, firefight is on. I don't think once you compromise concealment, there's any returning to stealth until everyone is killed. Which is kind of a shame.
I
kind of like Radio Guy. He seems fun. Work gloves.
Great work, Agent. We'll get that food back to the people who need it.
Okay. So the radio guy is like conspiracy theorist. I was right! I knew it! I was correct! I just can't wait until I complete this initial phase so that I can start customizing myself. Because I want to find the gear that I earned clicking on questionnaires on the Ubisoft websites. Because there were supposedly, I think it was like 5 packs of different like preset customization items, like for firemen, police, I think there was a hunter in there, several others. Stay strong, NYC. Somehow, I don't think the message took. You tried.
Agent, we've gotten word of a hostage situation at a bank. Looks like you'll have to go through the subway tunnel to access the building. We need you to move in and minimize the damage.
Who's taking hostages in... Oh, yeah. All right. Sure. Let's rescue some civilians, because why not? See, this is why I can't say I'm all that concerned to cover the entirety of the story, because it's pretty...
Cut and dry.
It's like... cut and dry, copy paste, kind of janky all over the place. The pacing is weird. Oh, there we go.
Becca says, I haven't been keeping up with the Division, but one of my good friends played the beta with 2 friends on console and played it for 30 hours in just a few days. So that was loads of fun later on.
Yeah, I played the hell out of it during the testing period, and I actually enjoyed it. The thing is, this introduction, it isn't selling itself well. I like.
The other introduction was better.
It was! Because this is just trying to treat itself like in medias res, where it's just like straight into the action. The thing is, it isn't as cinematic a start as the testing period. It isn't as much of a hook. It's just like, hey, you're, guess what? You're a secret agent. You're on the streets of New York now. Go solve crime. It's very... I don't know. It isn't impressive. What, there's a phrase I'm looking for.
No, it says they should have just set this in a Russian invasion of America. The
instruction
has crazy, you know,
that
would make so much more sense.
Mm-hmm. Russian, Chinese, a coalition, which is also kind of likely. Like, if this were a resistance in wartime, it would make a lot more sense. Even, you could even keep the secret agent kind of thing for it, you know? Like, if it's an agency that was supposed to foment cellular resistances in the case of foreign invasion. That would make sense.
No, it says also, how do agents get activated? An app, a text, Snapchat, carrier pigeon? Obviously that glowing ring on their wrist.
Yeah, it's the orange circle thing on their little comm devices. I guess someone's just sending them activation texts.
Yep.
Guess what? You got the orange lights. Consider yourself activated.
That guy says, at least take one from Dying Light and show the character being airdropped in.
Yeah, because that's the way it was in the testing period. I mean, at this point, sure. I'm sure that's coming, because...
Nice work shutting that down, Agent.
Oh.
Finally. Oh, thank you so much. That was...
for life.
That was it.
No, I need to get the hell out of here.
Yeah,
so do I. Color me underwhelmed. I don't feel like I just liberated the bank.
And why did they take this?
I know, like, there's a loot stash that can spawn weaponry in the room in which the hostages were kept. Come on, a little thought is all I ask for.
No, so do they just wear it constantly? Is it like a restaurant buzzer or an Apple Watch? Is there
seems
truly
like
an
it.
App for that? Maybe.
It seems like it.
I think you could look at the,
I think I just grabbed a meds. Can I read the paper? No, it's just a cover marker. Welcome! Alright. Like, there's so much potential here, and I know some of it it'll achieve. Because again, having played the test, I know what this game sort of comes into its own as, and that's the period I'm looking forward to, because that's when the fun happens. This introduction, though, it's just like the introductions of a lot of other Ubisoft creations, insofar as if I didn't already know that this game would improve, I'd have half a mind to just put it down right here. Because I ain't impressed, I ain't hooked. It just feels contrived. Can I drop? Thank you. And I know, like some of the, even the Far Cry games, and especially the Assassin's Creed games, some of them start very critically poorly, we'll say. And yet, once you kind of come into the part of the game that the primary component of its gameplay is comprised of, you know, that's when it kind of loosens up, it gets more fun, and it's actually an entertaining experience.
Agent,
those rioters have stolen a crate of morphine.
Mm-hmm.
Probably gonna try and sell it or use it. See if you can recover that crate.
Mm-hmm.
That guy says this
is
one hostage machine would be so much better if there were three
there
more enemies in a defense position, one more civilian, and the lootable weapon was in a locked closet.
Mm-hmm. Little changes could fix it.
Sparrow 5 here. We're approaching your position now.
It's just like only the most shallow level of thought was given
warning
to some of these mission parameters.
Yeah, Noah says also hate to be that guy, but isn't Eric supposed to be having a good time to, like, look at the right thing?
I haven't, actually. We've had a lot going on this past week, so I'm still just having skimmed through it a couple of days ago. This is our house! Is it? Is it? I'm about to light Hell's Kitchen up, man. Well, come on. Frag grenade? Yes, please. Oi! I assume they're in one of these containers. Alright.
And that gets us out in enemy bullet sponges.
Yeah. Those are some pretty resistant hoodies they got. Oh, I just had to hold the area. Okay. Cool.
Target is secure.
Does the rolling help?
Hostiles detected.
They've got no strategy. We can beat them.
Great work, Agent. We'll get those drugs back to the wounded where they'll be used properly.
Uh-huh. I approve. Carry on. Let's get moving. I like the concept of this game, and like, as a couple of people have said, with some small fixes, like just changing the location of the loot crate, having a few more enemies spawn, having the enemies actually seem like they care about holding the position that they've apparently cared enough about to take hostages in, to make sense. Little things could fix what's wrong with this. And again, just like a lot of Ubisoft things, it looks like it was just kind of pushed to release, just like, it's close enough. They're so incredibly focused on creating a convincing environment as far as the city, the level design, the world is concerned. Which is incredible, don't get me wrong. I mean, this is one of the most incredibly detailed, accurate, well-conceived cityscapes I've ever seen in any game. And yet, it's what's happening inside of that environment that isn't convincing and that undermines all of the work that went into the set piece.
No, this is hilariously, I'd say the beta was better.
So far. I'd agree.
Hey, don't walk away.
Fuck you!
Fantastic work, Agent. I think you put the lid back on this place just when it was about to boil over. We all thank you. And I wanted to say personally that I've lived in Brooklyn my whole life. So what you've done means a lot to me.
That guy.
Cheers, man.
Bulletproof pullovers and pistols in anarchic New York. What's not to love? Also, not a good sign that you're still negative less than an hour in.
Nobody's got a better.
And I admit, some of that is just my mood entering into this, because I'm tired, I'm fatigued. I haven't slept well the past few days, so I acknowledge I came at this kind of critical from the start. The thing is, though, a positive experience could have pulled me away from that. Instead, it's just pulling me farther, sinking in. Let's see. Do I want to sell anything? 870? Yeah, that thing was junk, I remember. So, getting rid of that. Keeping the M4. Got some armor. I need to actually equip some of this stuff. Work gloves. Do you do anything different? No, you are the exact same, so I can sell one of you. Cool. Alright, let me equip some of this stuff. Let's see here. Yeah, there we go. Mask. I kind of wish I could just, like, keep my mask on cosmetically all the time.
Like, no, it says, honestly, so far this game feels like a third-person Far Cry with a new location and fancy UI.
Pretty much. I can't say I disagree all that much with that statement. Alright, so do I like my MP5? Because I remember I loved the MP5 from the last time. Do I like this one? This does more DPS. It's more accurate, has a greater range, slightly lower reload speed, and just the tiniest peg, less stability. Yeah, we'll try the M4. Okay. Let's see here. So, there's a precinct siege. Actually, should I sell the stuff that I just disequipped?
It's in the bar right here.
Yes. Okay. Sell all of these. I'll keep my MP5 just in case I don't like the M4. Okay. And this guy's, like, callous, salesy attitude is getting on my nerves fast. Like, I'm cleaning up the streets, getting into firefights, and he's like, hey, don't walk away, I want to sell you shit. Knock that off. Because that isn't the way people, especially in a military capacity, which he's serving in, would act. Especially considering if the intro cutscene is correct, insofar as the powers and parameters of agents in service of the division are concerned, I have no oversight. I have no repercussions. I have no rules. I can do whatever the hell I want, so if I want to just crack him in the jaw for mouthing off, ain't nobody gonna stop me. What's he gonna do, fight me?
precinct back under control. If that precinct goes, we lose Brooklyn.
Hey, guys.
Hostiles incoming.
I recognize this from the E3 footage from, like, a couple of years ago.
That guy says, well, but hey, at least this game is better than Soul Raven. Almost any game
anything.
Is better than Soul
Raven. Anything. Because this is just, like, critical of a game. That game, though, that made me angry. Come on. Yeah, I recognize this gunfight. They showed this off in some of their promo footage.
No, it's like Teenage Humor. You have the promise of something funny, and occasionally you'll strike gold, but the rest of it is flat and falling pseudo-wit.
We've got an agent who's going to assist in the 84th, but all entrances are blockaded. Vision, that's the best news I've had all month. Try the parking garage in the back. Got that, agent? That's your in. Go get him.
I know the first wave already infiltrated the city. It seems like an awful lot of people know about this secret agency, the Division, though. I mean, they could explain that, in that, like, the JTF is advised that we exist. I don't know, it just seems a little strange. Whoop. Actually, like, provide cover fire for myself. Because if I fire on them, they kind of, like, take cover and recoil. So if I fire as I move from cover to cover, it's actually safer than just following the cover to cover move mechanic. Oh, geez, where'd he come from?
It says, I believe it was stated that the first responding wave all died or went MIA, so it was probably spread fast.
If no one knew about them when they went in, though, who's the news gonna spread amongst?
They're just gonna keep charging.
Like, clearly other agents of the Division would have heard about that. Other agencies, though? I don't know. I mean, unless they were given intel concerning the existence of the agency, it just doesn't seem like it fits. Hi there. Whoa! Hey! Come on with the teleporting. Hey. Am I melee in this game? I can't. Middle mouse, okay. Yeah. I mean, it would get annoying if I had to introduce myself and provide credentials about who I am, and then inform them that these credentials are legit, I know you've never heard of this, to every single character I come across. I get that. It's just, provide some dialogue about how these people know about us. That's all I'm asking for. Because so far, it seems like they have access to classified knowledge that their station, they shouldn't have. Well, he's very killed.
What exploded?
I think I shot a grenade in his hand.
Oh.
I think.
That would do it, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would do it.
That'll create kind of a mess.
Okay, I will be back, guys.
You will last, says the guy whom all of his friends just died. Come on, man. Come on. So, we're in the carpool. Kind of a shame vehicles aren't a thing in this game. Like, I know all the streets are crowded and you couldn't get around in most cars. Scooters? Like, cycles? Motorcycles? That kind of thing I think could still work. Do I really need that advisory at this point? Canned food, alright. Like, how many gunfights have I gotten into just on the way into this place? Presents. I see you. Keep him alive to negotiate. I disagree. Kill them all. Let God sort them out. Ow! The hell did he just hit me with? See ya. Ooh, he dropped loot. Alright, is there anything cool in here? I kinda wonder if this actually is the layout of this precinct. Because that would impress me. It's like somebody's handgun. Right? Outstanding achievements. Are there actually names on these? No. Because attention to environmental detail is something that Ubisoft has actually had for a long time, and they're actually fairly rarely praised for. Because stuff like this is the kind of thing that if I were making a game, I would absolutely agonize over, getting every little detail, especially if I'm trying to create a real-world place. You know, I would want to get that as correct as I possibly can. Thing is, though, when it's about a game, you gotta keep the core mechanics the focus. All the rest of this, as cool as it is, it's secondary. Hey, oh. Oh. Well. Armory. Hey now. And I'll blow your house in. I see someone actually made some use of the armory. Jeez. This place is thrashed. Civilian gas mask. Having that. Can I snatch up some of those shotguns? Nah, they're just there for decoration. Alright. I guess they could just hand wave it and say that it's of lesser value than even the stuff I started with. Alright, so he's in here. Can I chat with you? Yeah, I'm working on it.
Keep it down. Don't get them riled up. Play nice and give me time to get us out of here.
Play nice, he says. He's a funny guy. I like this guy. He's got jokes. Play nice. Cool.
Hey.
Department of Homeland Security? Okay. See ya. Can I actually read some of these? Almost. Let's see here. Sweep the upper floors. Jeez, all these missing persons reports. See, this is the kind of subtle storytelling that they should focus more on, because this speaks volumes. And I'll give their initial cutscene credit insofar as the, inoculated currency for how the virus spreads so quickly to so many people to infect. That was clever, in a very grim sort of way. Chow hall's clear. Restrooms. A rec room. I misread it.
All right. Alert. Hostiles detected.
Can I cover on the corner? Can dive headfirst into it. All right. I love that those, like, animation errors from several consoles ago are still a thing that can happen. Jeez. See, look at this. There's so many missing people, and they're trying to stitch the cases together across the city map. It actually seems like the level designers had more care for the story and the attention to detail than the people who designs the stories of the quests and the activities the player concerns themselves with. And that's a common thing for Ubisoft, unfortunately, in that a lot of these games are constructed very piecemeal, and a contiguous team doesn't create them. Multiple teams work at the same time to create different aspects, and then essentially a supervisory team then stitches it all into the final constructed product at the end. So that's how certain aspects of a lot of Ubisoft games can seem kind of incongruous. And like, a lot of attention was given to one thing and not to another, and they can seem a little confused. That's because honestly I think some of their studios are more talented and care more about their work than others. And in some cases, the ones that are, say, meant to come up with the quests, their work probably happens at least partially at the same time as some of the level designers, so they have to come up with certain, like, stages of the quest writing prior to the level design's completion, so they have to come up with essentially just pseudo-generic placeholder events that they can then shoehorn into levels that get finished later. And I know that's how they get games out, and they keep it from, you know, stretching into, like, 10 years of production. I know, that's just part of what comes with having a game this expansive, this large, this visually incredible, this complex. Certain standards just have to get cut for the sake of getting it out on time, such that the company can actually make a profit and keep making games at all. I know that, I get that. I just feel like there's at least a little communication should happen. And I know I'm probably speaking somewhat out of turn, because I'm sure more than a little communication happens. Classic. It just doesn't seem like enough happens. That the different segments that each partition of the team are working on are complementary enough to feel like a cohesive whole. It does feel like pieces of a game that were stitched together. This looks like Captain's quarters. His office. Quarters is where someone sleeps. He seems to have a fondness for pistols. I assume those are like trophies for pistol marksmanship or something. Toker School of Global Management? What? Alright, that's kind of ominous.
The conspiracy theorists were right.
This guy's actually got a picture up here. So I love all the attention to environmental detail. And apologies for going chat dark. Once she returns, we'll catch up. I just want to keep things moving, so. And there's so much attention to detail that I kind of feel like I'm missing things if I don't check everything. I like little Santa. He's kind of adorable. Let's see here.
Alert. Hostiles detected.
Whoop. Hi. Caught you sleeping. So my objective is to kill the leader. Someone's calling in flares. Contact.
Contact.
he just charging me with a grenade? Hey. Are you the man I'm here to kill? You have a nicer rifle than the rest. I assume I am correct. Secure the roof. Consider it secure. Climb down. Alright. What you got? Safety holster. Okay. You had an AK. Come on. Let's see. Anything else up here? Nope, seems like that's pretty much it. Oh, there's an AK. Oh. Inventory full. Alright, hang on. Let me ditch something. I think I am, unfortunately, going to have to ditch the MP5, because... What? Oh. There we go. It's just statistically weaker, and I do want the AK. It said I already have one. Did I actually pick that up? I guess so? Oh, that's saying I have grenades full. Alright, so I didn't have to get rid of that. Oh well, I've got parts. Because I didn't check into the crafting since it wasn't implemented for the testing period, so I figure why not? Let's see what that is. Release rope. There.
As the work agent, Brooklyn is stable again. Manhattan is another story.
Got another
Let's get over there and see for ourselves. A couple more agents with me now. We'll run in with Agent Lau fly over together. Commander Chang out.
Check. What? Again with the confused priorities. I'm getting the tutorial for what weapon stats mean now? After I've already tackled the first assignment? I've killed one of their enemy commanders? Yes, thank you, game. I know how to read the menus now. Pacing. Martial law is in effect. Deadly force authorized. And I'm getting the sprint tutorial tip here. Yeah, thank you. I think I can surmise my criticism so far that I can simply say it is an inelegant game. It isn't coming together smoothly. I like a lot of its component parts. They're just kind of TIG-welded together is all.
Hi.
Hello? So head to Manhattan. I anticipate this, since I think I hear a chopper.
I
think this is when the intro scene from the testing period comes up.
Hang on.
Cutscene.
Oh.
I'm gonna cut audio just so I cut down the echo.
Over there. There's a bar behind that building. Best whiskey sours in Manhattan. If we take this city back, I'll buy you a drink. Sorry. I mean, when we take it back. Here it comes.
B-22 Osprey. Cool ride.
The rest of us should be in this chopper. Can't believe it's finally happening.
Welcome, Agent.
That was a pretty quiet explosion.
Oh, fuck.
Honestly, I think this is where the game should have started. Wish granted! Lip sync is off.
And peers. I'm not sure what you're looking to get out of this. Everything behind this gate is a goddamn war zone.
So who's in command here?
Captain Benitez was in charge. He was leading ops in the post office, but we lost contact when he left base this morning. V still radio silent by tomorrow. There's talk of pulling out.
No one's pulling out. We're taking this city back. Get whatever gear you need. I'll catch up with you.
Good luck out there. Y'all made it.
That is where this game should have started.
Why didn't it start there? Like, why didn't it start with, like,
give me
the
one
cutscene and then, like, the explosion and then...
Yeah. Like, activate me on the street, put me through one simple firefight with a concise, paced-well tutorial for the controls, have me move to get to the Osprey, have it explode, cue this cutscene, consolidate everything that I just did in the last hour into 5 minutes, and you'd have so much more enticing a hook! Let me get out of these guys' way.
Noah is turning in for the night. I have a late arrival tomorrow, and I want to capitalize on sleep. Newt. That guy says, it's likely Hacker Dude hacked the government and found out about the division. And that
probably
guy says, did the colonel from Battlefield Friends unlock the silencer for his grenade? Why was that so quiet?
I guess. I don't know.
Also... I went downstairs for drinkage, and I found out that rice from dinner was still sitting on the counter, and I'm like, it's midnight, I should eat it.
Yeah, probably. And the cutout audio that kept coming in and out in that cutscene was kind of jarring.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like this game still needed a couple more months of polish, honestly. I know it got delayed once already. I think it needed to again.
Does this mean we're gonna have to? No, it said something, something. Osprey reliability.
You're good to go, okay?
Do we have to deal with the bitchy lady at our
Yeah. Because this is starting from scratch. What I want to check and see is if I have all the stuff that I put into my stash, because that was supposed to carry over from character to character. So I may still have some of that stuff.
That'd be cool.
Hi there.
Get a load of what I got here.
Yeah. You seem excited. Oh, I should probably check my gear to see if I have anything
to... It's not like I'm doing a whole lot of business anyway.
Yeah. Yeah, so we'll put that on. I should have. Yeah, I've got a new holster. Ugh. Ugh. It's statistically nice. I don't like the color. Pack. Get that. Oh, I need to be higher level. Damn. Do I have any extra sidearms? I do not. Let me check and see. Do I like the M4 or the AK? The AK is several hundred lower DPS, sadly. So we'll go with my new police M4.
So does that mean the two parents that we saw got activated in the cutscene are dead or missing? Is that what this is telling us?
If they were part of the first activation wave, then probably.
That sucks. That guy says, actually, I'm going to go with Nomad's idea and turn in.
Alrighty.
There's one here. Yeah, go ahead.
And at this point, as I said, I'm just kind of continuing on with the story. As far as the series is concerned, I ain't planning on covering the entire story because it's so disjointed. And I've already covered, I think, the essentials of it from the previous couple of streams. And it just doesn't seem like it's really the draw to this game. I think the combat and conflict and the scavenging and, like, especially the Dark Zone is, I think, where the actual enticement is. So I'm probably just going to play this in my own time, stream it when I feel like it, especially if I reach certain milestones and I want to, like, show off some stuff. If I come across any information that changes my admittedly fairly critical opinions of it early on, then that's when I'll cover it. And if there's just audience call for it, like, if y'all want to see some more of it, despite how critical I am of it.
Or some game jams.
Yeah, game jams of it. I would love to get some squad combat going on. Because the thing is, as critical as I am of it, I still like it, and I still see the potential, and I still want to like it, because I was hyped for this game for years, and
literally.
I want to see it succeed. Yeah, because I think I first heard of this game like 3 years ago at an E3, and
2013.
So yeah, and like I loved the concept, I loved the early art and promo and like alpha footage that they showed. I like what this is capable of. It just needs some polish to clean some of the little mistakes that are holding it so far away from its potential. And one patch could fix a lot of it. They really need to restructure that intro sequence, though, and that would take some work. It's still, though, like, the potential is there. And it isn't that nebulous, like, early access kind of potential. Like, no, Ubisoft has the funding, they have the people, they have the capability to put the work in, put a couple of months into it, set a team aside for it, fix it, they can make it happen.
Becca says, oh well, I'll be watching the remainder when it's uploaded to the YouTube.
Alrighty.
Night, have fun in Cali.
Indeed. Thanks, Mom.
Listen, they got me doing this radio business because I got the sciatica, but you can count on me to give you the info you need, honey.
Stop calling me honey. Cease, I say! Oh, hey, hang on. Since I'm at, like, the actual outset of the game here, can I access my custom stuff? Let me see what I do have, though. Yeah, I'll keep the dark ones. Let's see. Shirts. Can you stop turning away, man? I can hardly see you. You're all, like, fuzzy at the side of the screen. Why is the UI designed this way? It's overworked. They're trying to make it fancier than it needs. I can't really see a difference. No. Scarves? I don't have. Shoes. Sneakers, walking shoes. No, walking shoes. I am wearing sneakers. And hats. Okay, so pretty much cut and dry, it's what I have for now. So I need to check in with my stash, I think. So let's get moving.
Of course, you might not be a high enough level for your stash, so.
That's entirely possible. Some of my stuff was kind of low level, though. That was one thing I did like in the testing period, is that I could actually keep using certain pieces of gear as I continued. Oh, that's a grim addition. All the people in the lines trying to pass through quarantine.
Trying to get out.
Yeah.
Oh, this is dark.
Yeah. See, this is an effectual introduction. This sets the tone. This gives it the kind of feel, the friggin' rats crawling around the corpses, because you know they're crawling into those. This sets the feel. Ubisoft, discard everything I did in the last hour. All of that, it's crap. Trash it. This is where this game should open. Hell, it's even prettier here.
Mm-hmm. You even have a little bit of that lens flare.
Yeah.
And like the fallout. Little,
the cinematic effect, you know? I mean, whoever put the testing period together, they made some proper choices because they knew where the hook was that would actually sell games. They wanted to move copies, so they made a hell of a hook for their free testing period that they knew a lot of people were going to play, a lot of people were going to check into to see whether or not they wanted to make a purchase, and they knew that's where the hook is. Trust your instincts, man. Hey, leave the lady alone. Fucker. I am. Alrighty.
Why did they immediately assume that we're gonna shoot both of them?
I don't know. Why am I passing into a criteria area? I'm just kind of assuming that my map marker is showing me where I need to go. Unlocked a weapon slot. Cool.
Because you leveled up.
Yeah.
By running.
Get that hustle on.
You're starting to work.
Is this Morrowind?
Hang on. Let me check my map. So, yeah, there's a new mission there.
Coming in from the street. We're pinned down. Where's my backup? I've got no...
I'm a-coming.
We're coming.
New encounter. JTF support. Hang on. Got contact up here.
The water is so pretty.
It's a very pretty game.
Intercepting JTF radio traffic.
Taking small arms fire! Small arms fire! Look at us in their sight! JTF, hearing this? Please respond!
Tracking signal. Analysis complete. Uploading coordinates.
Gotcha.
Warning. Hostile forces approaching.
Push up. Goddamn tangos. I hate tangos. Oh, nope. Cover on the car. Don't crawl on the car. Ow.
Target secure. No more hostiles detected.
Cool. Quick release mag. I like that. Can I chat with this guy? Y'all seem happy. Doing a little victory dance. Hang on. What's in here?
Is it bad that I had the do a little dance?
Active echo beacon detected.
Okay, yes. Hey, puppy!
Here! Make a last, okay?
Classy folks.
So this is how we see what's happened.
Yeah, with our techno magic that somehow, I guess, forensically stitches the sequence of events together again.
Mm.
Complete with audio.
Well, we are in potential Watch Dogs universe, so...
Yeah, that's true. They
kind
of have...
Assassin's Creed universe.
Arcane technology. Sir Joshua O'Brien, current status active duty, occupation Sarah worker. Details, family relocated successfully. Well, kudos for you, sir.
Except, I don't think he made it.
Sarah supplies food, Greg Miller.
Mm.
Injured Sarah worker, critical condition, hospital. Can I check each and every one of these? Tony Morton, reported missing. Sarah worker, last seen in the garment district.
What about the other dude who was pulling stuff up?
Hostile rioter. Whoa, shit, getting shot at.
That doesn't pause things.
Nope. I thought I completed this mission. I saw tracers pass. I'm like, wait a minute. That isn't part of the simulation. Okay. So, alright, so red on the radar is an infected zone.
Alright. That was cool that we could, like, look at all the people.
Mm-hmm.
Can we look at it again?
Yeah, if I head over there again, I can check it again. Just, I've seen that one already.
Can we help him?
Need anything, man? You need a med kit? Sorry. I need those. If it was food or water you needed,
dispatch,
I'll help you out all day.
Division Agent Fei Lau, empowered and authorized by Executive Order and DHS Directive 51.
DHS?
Whoever you are, we're under a water assault. I'm not sure how much help you... Oh, screw it. We'll take anything you can give us. How are you on my cause?
We've got your back. Just try not to shoot at anyone who's trying to help you. Over.
In other words, don't shoot your backup.
Alert. Patching into local GTF radio channels.
I'm a coming.
Be advised, you have incoming division agents as backup to your location.
Let's get a little pincer on.
So they're DHS.
Yeah.
I guess that makes sense.
Oh yeah, because that's actually their area of expertise. Because I'd say this is certainly under the concern of the Department of Homeland Security. Hi. Kill all of his lackeys so we can concentrate fire on him. There we are.
Dispatch, situation outside is now under control. My official report, the division saved our sorry asses.
Thanks for the report, Bravo Squad. Stay alert out there and keep it frosty. I'm glad you made it.
Now let's rebuild our base. Go on in and have a look around. I finally got some transportation, so I'm inbound. Let's do this.
Hun, you should probably... take a
just
nap or something?
Settle in. Let the explosion heal.
I mean, she's got an eye injury at the least. She's got a bum leg. It's like, it's okay.
Yeah, she's kind of feeling the hurt.
Air ventilation and purification systems online. Contamination levels lowered.
I still think this is a clever loading screen.
Yeah. Jake Awesome says, hey guys, got the divisions back.
Cheers.
We need our base up and running, and we need to show the people of New York they're getting their city back. Our base of operations has potential, but right now it's a piece of shit and we've got no one to staff it. To get this place where it needs to be, we need people who know what they're doing. Like doctors. There's a virologist running a field hospital over at Madison Square Garden, but the whole area's gone to shit. With her, we can get our medical facilities online. Without her... the JTF commander, Benitez, is out in the field, and he's gone offline. Bring him back. We need him to set up a functional security wing, and it'll do a hell of a lot for morale. We've also got to restore basic services. We need power, and the intel the grid can give us. They had a guy working on that, but it sounds like he ran into trouble patching us in. Without him, it's lights out. Isaac can map himself to each of the wings in the base and sync their progress so we can have a bigger picture of what's happening here. And the more stable this base is, the better shape the city will be in.
So I'm going to focus on security first, because that's the objective I would set.
And we need the morale anyway.
Yeah, because the thing is, if we establish either of the others without security to keep it safe, we can't control it. It's just going to get stolen straight from us.
Check your stash while we're here.
Yeah. Let's see here. Have I kept any of my stuff?
Why is
that's just
empty?
Me. I was afraid of that. I wasn't counting on getting to keep anything from the testing period. I was like, where is my stuff from the missions I complete? Like, I can't act all that indignant because it was just a little promo thing on a website. I activated the code, though, through Steam and Uplay.
Jake says, I was watching strange. Josh OG yesterday, and he has all legendaries already and one-shot a boss.
Cool.
When did this release? Like,
2 days ago. Okay. Let me check. There we go. Get some improved armor. Get my new pack, because now I'm proper level to wear it. I've got some stuff I can customize with. I think I'm going to hang on to that, though, because I'm not completely fond of this rifle, so... Gear.
If I don't have it, you don't need it.
That's awfully arrogant and presumptuous. Well, I know I don't need my old M4. So, well, that is my old one, right? I think. Let me check.
Well, that was disappointing.
Ah, shut up. Okay, so as I gained levels, the numbers increased. Because I remembered it had... like 1500, and that's what the one that was showing up in the inventory
was. You
have to
check this out. Nobody's going to give you a better deal. All
right.
Jake says, school's in morning, 1 and 16 a.m., but who cares? I don't need sleep.
Sleep is for the weak.
Can't wait till tomorrow, so I can't sleep as it is.
Take good care of that gear, but it'll take good care of you.
That's better.
You think?
Okay. Hey there.
Well, so you're a division agent, huh?
Cheers.
Great. Now, don't dwell on all the death and carnage around you or the fact that so many have tried to do what you're about to attempt and failed and died what surely must have been a horrible death. Sure, they have more support than you do now, but so what? Fate's random and heartless.
You think?
Nothing you can do about that. Stay positive. I'm just, real glad it's gonna be you out there in the field, not me. But I'll let you know what we got. Okay?
If we hit the
Can someone extract this lady? Because she is actively sabotaging morale. That is actually a tacit threat to the security of this entire facility and everyone in it. So I'm gonna say that's grounds for having you summarily extracted from this entire area.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks. Guess what? I have more authority than you. See ya.
Remember, personal hygiene is important in combating green poison. Be sure to wash as often as possible.
So I'm gonna check each wing.
The tech wing has obviously seen better days. But if you can get Rhodes back here, he's apparently got a lot of tricks up his sleeve. Mm. Former PMC, I think.
Those
more than you think he does. I suspect he'll be very useful.
His French trip to Quebec is tonight to Sunday.
Yeah, cool.
Gotcha.
Enjoy. I'm taking a trip pretty soon myself.
Yep.
We're heading out to California for about a week.
The security wing needs some love. And Captain Benitez. The JTF loved the guy. He can mobilize them and help us get the intel and firepower we need to get all these hostiles off the streets.
Okay. And lastly, checking in on medical.
The medical wing is a wreck right now. Once we get that virologist over here, we can build up a staff, investigate the origin of the virus, and start getting more supplies. For civilians, but for us as well.
You can't buy from over there.
Hey, bad news. I'm not going to be able to get out there. Not with my goddamn leg like this.
I'll do what I can from here, but it's not the same. You have no idea how much I wanted to be in the field. I trained for a scenario like this my entire life, but it's worse than anything we could have imagined. You know how they won't let you get too close to anyone, so it won't mess you up when you're finally activated? Well, I did that, and it didn't fucking work. I'm attached. These are my people. This is my city. We're taking it back. Oh.
Look, you need to...
Yeah, okay. Okay. They're counting on us. Let's not let them down.
Supposed to be friends with anybody.
Uh-huh. Action completed, gain a foothold. So I got U points. Yay. Mm-hmm. Cheers for that. What's this? Is this like a job panel?
Hey, what you looking for?
Good luck out there.
So that's syncing my map, I think. Yep. Cool. Alright.
Where does they used to use the
password? So, let me see here. How do I get the stuff? Is it in here? Clothing. Ooh, redeem code.
Yes.
That's probably where I get it. Hang on, I can actually alt-tab to get that.
Jake says, I'm so happy I got on it. Only 48 of us get to go, and I was picked and had the grades I need. I got lucky. If it was based on last year, I wouldn't get to go.
Congrats, man.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, copied. Please tell me I can just... There we go. Activate. Already active on this account. Please visit your game's library to access your games. So, how do I get my stuff? Rewards? Ubisoft Go Bag. Concept Arts. Rainbow Six Siege Tactical Suits. That's 0 points, so sure. Unlock that, I guess. Shortbow's Sports Jacket. Unlock. Sure. Master Crafting Kits. Iconic Division Jackets.
Jake is going full screen, but he's still here.
Alrighty. Centurions, Phoenix Credit. So it isn't in the rewards tab on Uplay. Oh wait, hang on. Ubisoft Club Go Bag. Adds a collection of essential items to the rewards claim vendor. Perfect for the recently activated agent. Gives you 3 medkits, 500 credits, and assorted crafting materials, grenades, and consumables to get you started. So that isn't it. I mean, it's useful. That isn't what I'm looking for, though. Maybe everything is at the rewards claim agent. Let me check that. Uh-huh. So, where is that guy? Aha, there we go. So, weapons, gear, mods, story. Crafting. Is it in here? That's the security wing. You're kind of off on your own. Rewards claim. Here we are.
See something you like?
Here we are. All right. This is all my stuff. Cool. So that's how
I
find
it. It's all free.
And it doesn't look like it has any level restrictions. Oh, it does. It's level 4. Which I am.
You are.
Cool. I just, like, take it all. I have so much stuff.
I think you're gonna have to select them.
Let's see. Retrieve. Let me just... Can I just spam space? There we go. Collect it all! Cool. Alright.
Yay!
Cheers, sir.
We just got a bargain.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah.
It was all free.
Cases and cases of stuff for free.
Do you want to put stuff on?
Yeah. Let's see. Let me get into the lights. There we go. All right. Now let's customize a little, shall we? So armor. I didn't actually get any armor. I did get some weapons. So I have a lot of stuff. Funny enough, these aren't actually all that statistically fantastic. What is this thing, though? EMT P416. That's just another HK416 sort of thing. Hazmat P416. So they're different colors. Okay. Well, since these are, like, special, I'll stash them. And...
Jesus, imagine if it was Fallout. You would have had to take an hour walk back to stash all that stuff.
Yeah. Did I get any other sidearms? No, still the M9. I did get another pack, I think. Yeah, here we go. Can I turn around so I can actually see the damn thing? Jeez, why can't I swivel my character around to preview my gear? Come on. Paramedic, police, hunter. Let's just start at the top and see what happens. So that increases my primary DPS. Hang on. Oh, come on. Alright, so that's like orange. Let's see, what else? Ooh, yeah. Okay. Stay standing like that, character man! I want to see these. Alright. That's got reflectors on it. That's got, like, a camo pattern. That's got a lot of med gear on it. That's acceptable. So CBRN or police. Let me see what the police looks like. That's got, like, zip ties and shotgun shells. I think I'll stick with the CBRN for now. Cool. Alright. Anything else I should switch out? I think that is a negatory. So, appearance. Let's see here. Oh, come on. Can I shift the camera around? Is that, like, a thing I can do? Maybe don't move the character, just move the camera. Swivel it around him. Come on, game! These are little things. There we go. So, simple jacket. Jacket. Can I preview these by clicking on them, or do I have to equip them?
I think you're gonna have to click
yeah.
on. Oh!
Yeah, no.
What's the normal jacket?
Jacket, that's the kind of Azure one. Police jacket? Paramedic? Firefighter? Well.
Simple jacket.
Simple jacket it is. Scarfs. I didn't get any. Pants! So I'm wearing military. Siege pants! Those are jeans. With some kind of weird ends. Okay. Police pants. Paramedic pants. And hunter pants. Yeah, sticking with the military. So, I was agonizing over getting all this free stuff and I don't like any of it. Shirts. So, training hoodie. Simple. Siege shirt. Ooh, I kind of like that. It's got a collar to it. Hunter shirt. CBRN specialist shirt.
It's an emergency service announcement. Due to the possible risk of infection, all
I'm thinking that one for now. Although, it does kind of conflict with some of the waist area. So I'll stick with that. Shoes! I have a lot. Police. Paramedic. Hunter. Firefighter. Sure wish it wasn't so fuzzy. Coloration-wise, I think I'm gonna go paramedic. Alright! So now, stash some stuff. There we are. Put pretty much all of these in there. What? Come on. What is with that delay?
No idea.
Okay, alright.
Good luck out there. You'll be missing out.
Let me see. Can I customize some of my weapons? Because I'm not entirely fond of this. I think I recall weapons are moddable. However, I don't think you can transfer mods from one to another. Can you? Actually, no, you can. There we go. Initial stability and just stability. Oh god, why? Oh, it's so hideous. Alright, going with that. Magazine. Quick release. Ah, I need to get level 5. Optic. Ooh, hey there. Holosight. I approve. Okay, so I need a level so I can get the quick release. Cool. Let's keep moving. Let's carry on with this Slavic manly man. Okay. Tutorial matchmaking. Cool. You can invite other agents to your group, walking up to them pressing tab. You can invite and join from the group management menu, or you can use matchmaking to find a group from the matchmaking stations around the map. Alrighty.
Can you just go on your own?
Because I want a solo. Mm-hmm. That's what I feel like doing. Hello, someone just dropped the mask. And it's kind of crappy, so I'm keeping it there. Let's see. Let me check the map. Are there any side quests I can just go do? Because that sounds like fun. I could go find a safe house. New encounter. That's the security guy, I think. Let's head to that encounter, shall we? Alright. I anticipate I'll probably play a lot of this game solo.
Yeah.
Because I like the fact that, like, it is, actually, I said this about the testing phase. I can commend this game for absolutely shaking up the standard genre formula for an MMO, because that's what this is. It doesn't play like one at all. It's very much a cover shooter with MMO architecture.
Marked hostile headquarters detected.
And I like that. I also like the fact that if you're careful, you can actually play this pretty much solo. I just had to time it that way. I had to. These teleporting enemies are getting annoying. Oh. Alright, that little stability increase isn't so little. It's making a notable difference in the controllability of this rival. Assault the stronghold. Can do. Hey guys. Catch. Hey, get away from me. Hey! Don't you run from me!
Hostile HQ neutralized. GTF dispatch informed.
Ah. What do we got? Weapon parts. I hope the crafting is cool. I just don't hope it gets in the way of things. Sure. Is that an improvement over what I have? Equip. Sure. Mechanical holster. I think that green arrow means it's an improvement. So, equip. Hey! And it's a color I like. All right. I know. Form over function. Isn't always a great thing. I am guilty of it, though. Okay, so... Oh, wait. I don't know this area. Yeah! I knew this area. Hello, drone. Come on down. Civil disturbances, JTF responded with controlled measures of force. This image shows a group of JTF personnel holding the line against Violet attackers. Alright. Can I check those images anywhere? In an archive or something? I kind of hope so. Oh, camera. Camera, come on. Alright, I need to get down there. Because I see hostiles. Again, though, on the, you know, if all you have is a hammer, every problem looks like a nail. I just wish there was some kind of ability from the start, because if there is one that I can get access to later, that's cool. It isn't all that well implemented then. That could let me talk to enemies, to chat them down. Because honestly, if you want to take a city from people like this, connecting with them and reaching their leaders to make compromises is how you do it. Just crushing them with force isn't the way. Because that just creates a power void. And that's just going to get filled with someone else. You have to reach a point of understanding, even if that means making uncomfortable compromises. If you're trying to tell me that these people aren't willing to compromise, then it's taking a very cynical view of humanity. That there are so many people that are, just because of the removal of the rule of law, intrinsically evil to the point of killing and looting for what they want. I mean, it just, it speaks more about the persona and the worldview of the writer of the scenario than it does about people. Because that isn't the way people act. People are inherently cooperative, even in, and especially in, an emergency scenario. It's just the way we're, you know, mechanically programmed as a species. Hostage key. There we go. Let's let these poor sods out.
Civilians secure.
Hey there. I love that little nervous wave, just like, hey. Find the sun, whatever the season.
Thanks.
Okay. Corrections armor. Take it, because I don't think that's as good as what I'm currently wearing.
Jake said, seems like The Walking Dead, how they see and kill other people.
Pretty much. Let's see.
What the hell are you doing? You're hurting him!
Listen up. Yeah. Safe house. Another encounter. Yeah, let's go and connect with the safe house. The cavern, they call it. Alright. Whoop. Contact left. Oh! Oh, he's a cleaner. Have fun. Maybe you shouldn't try to torch civilians. Just a thought. No. Ain't torching me either. Oh. Frick. Ah, crap. Yes. It is kind of interesting that the disoriented condition actually screws with your controls.
Jake says you should totally go to the Dark Zone.
This early? I'm waiting until I get some...
It was the Kappa face.
Once I get some superior gear, hell yeah. This early? Yeah. This place seems very contaminated. What is this? Incident report discovered. Oh. It's a laptop. Rule number 2. Ryder tells friend how to handle himself.
Now, sometimes they want to hold on to their shit at any cost. Might even try to kill you to protect it.
Yeah, I've seen that. In that case, measure up the biggest guy they got and shoot him in the head. Just drop that guy, and the others will listen. Remember, he'd do the same to you if he could. Point blank, right, Dad?
Got it. With kids, it's even easier. Just aim at the kid and they'll back down. No need to waste the ammo. If they got a dog, you can either threaten the dog or take it out. And if you got the guts to do it, you can even bring it back here and roast it.
Wait, you mean you eat the dog?
Hey, it actually tastes all right, if it's lean.
No!
Yeah.
We never eat the puppy. There's better shit to eat around here.
Well, they threaten dogs, that's it. Kill them all, sort them out, rioters all need to die. What are you doing?
Do you need help, dude? Are you okay?
Doing interpretive dance over here?
We don't
Meanwhile,
have a problem, do we?
He's having marital problems over here. Hey, doggies. How are you? I still want to, give them food and have a puppy friend. I really want that.
Alert. Intercepting JTF radio traffic.
Thank you, small arms fire! Small arms fire!
Oh. Everything clear?
Morning.
I mean, I know he's on fire. Coming from where? Whoa. Okay, you're a friendly. What are you doing, man? They're that way! Stop it!
We got cleaners.
So we do. Where are they?
Sweet. It's some psychos.
Everyone clear? No, there's still something pinging on the radar this way. Where are these guys?
Warning. Hostile forces approaching.
Uh-huh. Gina Esteban, what the... Wait. Loading agent. Agent trace found. What is this? I can't afford to stick around here. All right. Come on.
Area secured. Hostiles neutralized.
Okay. Small grip. Having that. Can I unshield now? Shield, there we go. Just throw it away. Okay. So I got another weapon. Yeah, this thing. MP5A4. Drastically reduced accuracy and range and lower damage. So, as much as I like MP5s, that's a no. Armor-wise, though, what would you do for me? You would actually improve my DPS. You would lower my health, though, a fair amount. So, that's a no. Mask-wise, I'm already wearing that. Armor. Ooh, protective pads. Yes. Armor from hands, work gloves, having those. And holster, keeping mechanical. Alright, cool.
Jesus.
So, consult the map. Where to? Oh. Still checking in with the safe house. Let's get moving. Oh! Hi! Could you not? Motorcycle pads. Unlocked a skill slot. Cool! Alright, that was L to get to abilities. Alright. I think I'll get the ping. And equip that to Q. Cool. So now, inventory, armor. Motorcycle pads, far superior in pretty much every way. And it increases my kill XP. Excellent. And it's a color I like. All round victory. Now, for my gun. Mod. No, not that one. That one. Since I'm level 5 now, I can attach my new magazine mod. There we are. Do I have anything else I want to attach? Underbarrel. Small grip. Accuracy is nice. I think I'm actually enjoying the stability more, though. So we'll keep that as is. Cool. Jeez, this game's pretty. And the thing is, as much as I criticize the intro, I'm enjoying it so much more now. This is where the fun kicks in.
Echo available for playback nearby.
This is where the game comes into its own. I just don't see why it didn't start here. Shelter inside. Is this our safe house? In the sewer?
You are now entering a safe area.
I see what they call it, the cavern, then. Yeah. This place seems of questionable sanitation. Can now fast travel here. I like these interiors. Whoa, what was that? Hang on. Safe houses. Every safe house offers missions and encounter locations. Services like vendors, ammo, restock, and new respawn locations are also available. Safe houses are social hubs where you can meet other agents or use matchmaking stations to find a group. Open the map, select any unlocked safe house, and press X to fast travel there. Got it. Take what you need. Free supplies. That's awfully generous. Seems like they certainly have a stockpile. It's a little laborious to actually get in here, though. Oh, with all the ladders and stuff to climb. Okay, well, gear vendor, let's sell some of my extras. That's a decent DPS on that thing. I'll hang on to it for now. The rest of this I think I'll get rid of. Angled grip, the red one. I just can't.
Come back soon.
Restock. There we are. Hey there.
Best gear in the city.
I'll be
Check
point
it out.
Contact in this area if we get into any trouble. But in the meantime, I don't want to say that you have a very transformative presence. I feel like we're going to have an osmosis of energy convergence as a result of your positivity. I'll let you know if I hear something.
Really?
Cool.
It's not gonna lie, I think the prettiest moments in a video game was right after the New York City mission while flying away. You've seen it.
I haven't actually played that game, so I couldn't
what
tell
is,
you.
What is that game?
Call of Duty Modern Warfare 3.
Shield family says hi.
Hey, cheers. A little late for you. This guy's one of the new age hippie types. Who just uses words he doesn't fully understand to sound cool. Ah, pseudo-intellectualism. Alright, so that's just my stash. Anything I want to put in there? Not at the moment. She seems upset.
She can't sleep.
I know that feel. Very well indeed.
Best gear in the city. Check it out.
In the sewers. In here.
Morning.
Oh.
You are now leaving the safe area.
It's the way out. Alright. Is this a little more concise than the way I came in? And you know the people that work the maintenance in any given city, they get a workout, man. Because they have to traverse this kind of environment every day. Showing a little love to the people that never get acknowledgement. Let's see here. Alright, so that was the safe house.
She took a 3-hour nap.
Yep, I know that feeling. When you lay down, you're like, yeah, I'm gonna sleep for 10 hours, and you wake up like an hour and a half later, and the body's like, nah. Nah. System disagrees.
You're an inspiration to us all.
Carry on.
There's all kinds of crazies out there.
Speaking of crazies. I think I'll hit this encounter, and then I might cap off the stream with the mission to secure the security guy, since that mission wasn't in the testing phase, which I covered to completion. So, it isn't critical to me to cover that again. The security guy, though, since that's one of the, like, foundational characters for establishing one's command center. That's rude! Shut up! Then, I think I might check him out, just so people can kind of see the intro to the game. A DRM. DMR. DRM is something completely different. It's late. I'm tired. Cut me some slack. Ha! One shot. And there's the kill. Probably makes me a terrible person.
Dark zones rolled off, and with good reason. It's where the infection hit hardest, to the point where no one, not us, not LMB, not anyone, could hold it. Now it's a no man's land, full of people willing to take their chances with the virus to get away from the factions in the streets. And what happens behind those walls? Well, very little of it is good.
This is Sparrow 2. We're closing on your position.
I went from where, man?
Warning. Hostile forces approaching.
Yeah, I heard the other guy. Oh, there he is. Could you not crowd my camera? Thank you. Seems like shots can't pen that. Oh! You mind?
They're gonna try to
I'm trying to kill your friends here. Yeah, guys, I think we're clear. Still have a minute 39, though. Whoop. They have changed their approach.
Found a copy of an old written story from senior year, so I'll reread what I have and type it out for changes.
Nice. It's always weird when you reread something you wrote a long time ago and you're like, I wrote this? I don't remember coming up with this. Ooh, hollow sight. Having that. Hey. How'd that whole assaulting a fortified position thing work out for you?
Jake is gonna go.
Alrighty. Have a good one, man.
Warning. Hostile forces approaching.
Oop. And catch. Oop. Shattered his shield.
It's been 19 years since shield.
Like that guy's got an LMG. Jesus. Have a grenade. There we go. Oh, it set up a turret. That's what I was hearing. Enjoy.
Area secured. Hostiles neutralized.
We got cleaners.
Hey, thanks for the assist.
Whew. That was kind of an intense firefight.
Remind me never to fight you.
Glad you were with us.
Hey, thanks for the assist.
Might have you with us in every firefight.
Okay. So now where to? What is that? Oh, Dark Zone entrance. Alright. So that's why she gave me the explanation of what it was. I'm essentially right next to it. Side mission. Dr. Candle needs you to find an old associate. I'll check that out later. I think I'm going to try and find the security guy. Let's see.
What the hell are you doing? You're hurting him!
Listen up. I spent 6 years in medical school. I don't give a shit what you...
Candle. That's Rhodes.
We're getting overrun! They're killing everyone in sight!
There he
is. Damn it, if they blow open the
This tunnel is the major supply line for food, meds, and weapons from the outside world. But we've got a group of rioters with explosives trying to break through the quarantine there. The JTF garrison is doing its best to hold the line, but they're weakening. And if the rioters blast through the floodgates, the tunnel floods, the supply line's cut, and a whole lot of people die. We've got confirmation that Benitez is there in the thick of it. We need that location secured, and Benitez back here at base.
Jill says,
check.
Found an old box and it was in it. Lucky for me, the paper and ink that I use is meant to be used to archive with.
Ah. So that means it's actually kept well all those years. You're welcome. I like you. I kind of shot at your husband, though. I didn't shoot at him, because that was the same window. I shot near him to startle him, to teach him a lesson. I'll just keep moving. What do I do with these? Can I, like... Oh. Wait a minute. this? Ah. Alright. Put it here.
Data scanned. Downloading files.
The medical staff doesn't have a lot to work with. We're dangerously low on basic supplies like painkillers. So I've got a plan B here. There's a nurse I know. Used to know. He's got a reputation for knowing where to find hard stuff. And by find, I mean... who cares what I mean? Normally, I wouldn't make his acquaintance again, but turns out he's a resource and we need those meds badly. Find him. I'd start by checking his apartment.
So, wait. Am I getting missions from Candle, even though I haven't liberated her yet? Is that seriously a thing that's happening right now?
Yes.
I'm kind of glad that I completed as many missions as I could in the proper sequence for the testing phase. Because that was actually pretty well paced. This? This is a janky mess! I mean, maybe that was pre-recorded? I guess? I don't know. I want to like this game. It's little things that are keeping it from achieving what I know it's capable of. It just isn't trying. Sets up a meeting with a potential buyer. Okay.
Oh, you're getting the mission because this is his apartment.
I know, I just... Even if I came here, I wouldn't know the significance of it without her to tell me.
Yeah. I don't know.
Again, pacing. Kobe card. Kobe's Club loyalty. Collect stamps. Eat for free! Details well worn. Uh-huh. Michael Dufresne, current status missing.
Look, I don't usually carry that kind of stuff.
Hey, come on. We got water, we got food, we got batteries. You bring me this stuff, it's all yours.
Okay, fine. Just need to get the usual up on West 39th.
So he's got a warrant for drug possession and distribution, and he has a stolen Sarah badge. Name redacted, clearance orange.
Shield says, it seems like I have three different starts at the story, with one of them being dark.
Drug samples. Property of Vexix Co. Not for resale. Prescription drugs. Oxycodone, hydrocodone, codeine, lorazepam, amphetamine, sulpidem, morphine, and alprazolam. Yeah, that's heavy stuff, alright.
Yeah, that's some pretty heavy. Cool tri-climate jacket.
You need to have wool, not that synthetics.
I think we'll take whatever we can get.
Pretty much. Okay. I'm gonna head out now. So... How do I leave quickly? Can I just head down the stairs? I'm just gonna keep heading toward our security commander. Because he's the one I'm actually concerned about. He's the one whose mission I want to cover.
I hate to tell you this, my beloved, but I'm getting really dang tired.
You can head out if you want.
Huh?
You can head out if you want.
Huh?
Yeah. And I've just got one mission I want to let do next. I don't know how long it is, though.
Because I got up many hours before you.
This is kind of intense.
Active echo beacon detected.
I don't care. I have things to do. These are whiteout conditions.
I think I am gonna head to bed.
Okay.
I'm just really tired.
Alrighty.
I'm sorry, though.
Yeah, it's fine. I will check on chat periodically once I reach stopping points. So, apologies for the kind of,
sorry, guys.
Cutting in and out of contact with chat. What are this? Agent Trace, Ray Ortiz. Alright, I'll check into more of those.
I bet those are the MIA agents.
Yeah, those are the first wave people.
There are some cleaners menacing some people. We need you to intervene.
Who the hell are you?
I'll do some creative visualizations in the meanwhile as a form of remote support.
It's the dude who is like osmosis tech dude.
Okay.
He's the creepy osmosis tech dude.
Alrighty then, Osmosis Jones.
Alright, I'll actually be back in just a minute, because I'm going to take this stuff down first.
I guess I'm calling the stream here then! Never mind!
Does that mean they're down for maintenance and they didn't tell us?
I guess...
I didn't hear the stream blip.
No, that's not the stream connection issue. That's the game's servers acting up. Because I heard on their first day, they had a lot of issues. It's why I didn't cover it day one, even though I could have. Because I heard the horror stories coming from a lot of people that were having connection issues. They were running into a lot of their, like, named errors. And it seems like only a very small fraction of people were actually able to connect and play the friggin' game at launch. And that kind of colored a lot of the earlier reviews and everything. And the thing is, it's just, I actually agree with what Noah said earlier. The closed and open betas were better.
Yep.
This is just a janky, dare I say, just soulless, hollow mess of a game at launch. What happened? It really feels like the same sort of phenomenon as what we see in trailers commonly. That... they showed us for the period that was meant to sell the game. Because let's face this honestly. Beta periods are, for AAA companies, absolutely, certainly, less about any kind of testing. They aren't stress testing their servers much.
I mean, they are.
I mean, they are. The real, like, Q&A...
has already been done.
Yeah, all of that is taken care of. All they're really trying to do, let's face this honestly, is sell more copies because they're counting on the fact that people are going to get hooked after playing it for a weekend and pre-order. Mm-hmm. That is what those are for, as far as AAA companies are concerned. It isn't what they should be for. That's what they treat it as though it is for, though. And I really feel like they cut up and paste, and that whoever actually like oversaw that did a improved superior job than what the main game designers did, the core highlights of the game. They took the choicest pieces, stitched them together, and then said, here, this is what the main game is going to get comprised of, and yet the rest of it, the meat, maybe I've just had a sour run this evening, because I know I ran into some glitches.
Yeah, we'll try again. I mean,
I will stream this again. I'm going to keep playing it. I just, like, if this were the experience that I'd had during that testing period, I would not have ordered the game.
No.
Absolutely not. Had I had the experience that I did, though, I was sold. I had so much fun, especially at the end. It was so freaking cool. This one, though?
So, Shield says, I came up with a Fallout idea of the courier helping both the Lone Wanderer and the Soul Survivor, along with the courier being related to the Vault Dweller and the Chosen One.
Cool. I like those kind of stories. So, I don't know. I've just had a very disappointing run
with this tonight.
With the Division this evening, which is sad. Because I was so hyped for this.
Hype is the downfall of many games.
It really is. I don't know. It feels contrived. I think my main criticisms, if I were to come up with three, are the pacing.
Oh.
the incongruent focus upon environmental storytelling and then the just contrived actual storytelling that's at the active part of the narrative. And I would just say a lot of the lack of care to actually hook players, to make the characters convincing. I think those are the three main issues I have, because the combat is solid. It isn't innovative. It's just a standard cover shooter. The MMO portion of it is serviceable. I mean, we played it, and we had a fun co-op squad time of it during the testing phase. It just... The
Faye
meat...
Faye is my favorite part.
Yeah, she's cool. I like her.
She's a hard ass.
Yeah.
She's cool. But the rest just, of it is just...
To have this evening's experience cut short... with a server error is just...
That's kind of the way... That's just a perfect end, like... That is how this whole thing has been.
It's like the spoiled cream left out overnight on top of an already stale cake.
Ouch.
That's just...
That burn, yo.
I'm sad now.
I know.
Hopefully, when I cover this game again... I'll have a more positive experience, because like I said, now that I've come into the main phase of the game,
yeah,
that's where the fun lied in the testing phase when I first played it. And that's what I enjoyed the most. Mm-hmm. And I can see myself just kind of passing some hours solo playing side missions and the randomly respawning encounters and stuff that aren't even side missions as far as the consideration. So... Yeah. Can I actually...
Does space do anything? Click space. You have to reconnect so you can
I have to connect so I can disconnect.
Yes.
Ubisoft! Hashtag WTF!
I just realized what the other option... Like, those are the same things that you get in the Echo.
Oh, the... Yeah, it's the same kind of thing. I'm so happy they're delaying the next Assassin's Creed, because I would hate to see that series end up the same way the last couple of entries in that series have, and the way this has. Ubisoft need to take their time. That's the thing.
Because they have great ideas.
Yeah, they do. They have excellent concepts. And they just failed to execute them well in the last few years.
They just need to take their time and really get the concept down and get the mechanics to match the concept and polish.
Yeah.
A polish.
And cohesion, I think, is the one aspect of games development I want Ubisoft to focus on. Because I know since they piecemeal the creation of their games to so many different studios and then stitch them all together at the end... That is how a lack of cohesion happens, because the different teams have different visions, they have different goals, they have different objectives, they have different policies, and then those don't all match. So, like, I don't know how at a corporate level, and on a game with the sort of scale that this has, one would solve that issue. That isn't what I'm here to talk about. I'm just saying that it is an issue, and that at that level, that's something they need to concern themselves with, because it is starting to show in their products consistently.
Which is not a good thing. Ubisoft, but no, that's bad.
Yeah. So, I think that's pretty much all of the criticism I can levy, at least with any sort of validity, considering I have only seen a limited aspect of the game so far. It may improve. I hope it does.
We hope so.
So, call and stream there. Kind of a low point. I'm sad. So, cheers. I still have a few episodes I want to record prior to leaving town. This is probably the last stream. Prior to leaving town, though. So, as far as live stuff is concerned, I will check in with y'all once we return, probably at about a week and a half from now. So, I am Kinsmarck here at Last Level Press.
I'm Violeta.
And as always, wish you all good gaming and Godspeed.
Bye!
And no, we wait. Cheers, everybody.
Take the button. Boop.
I have to wait.
The boop.
I have to wait so it doesn't cut off the outro.
Okay. But boop.